The central perception of Gnosticism, no matter how you slice it, is that we don't belong here, that we are strangers, that something terrible happened, and that accounts for why we're here, that we were destined for a much better deal, and something went terribly, terribly wrong. It takes different forms. Some Gnostic mythologies are fairly straightforward, some are fairly Baroque. The one that I enjoy is one of the more Baroque ones. The second century Gnostic Bishop Valentinius had this notion that there were 36 archons. They are demons of progressively lessening power that interpose themselves between man and a true vision of God. And the last of the archons, the 36th archon, was Sophia, and the only of the archons that was female. There's a tremendous sexual ambivalence in Gnosticism, which we can talk about, which is resolved in different ways. But anyway, the 36th archon is Sophia. She looked upward toward the higher God and saw him bring forth creation, of which she was the final manifestation. And in her heart, an avarice grew, a wish to create in the same manner as the highest and hidden All-Father. And she brought forth, it's described as an abortion. She self-fertilized herself. She did not understand the requisites of creation, and she turned inward into herself, and she brought forth a monstrosity. And this monstrosity is the God of the Old Testament, Yahweh, Jehovah. And when she saw what she had done, that she had brought forth this monstrosity, she flashed through a whole bunch of emotions very quickly. Horror, guilt, rage, fear, agony, like that. And these emotions of the errant Sophia condensed as the material world over which Ildabaoth was then made lord. So the entire material universe is seen as the condensed emotional debris of the horror of the 36th Archon upon witnessing her own creation, who is then made God over this universe. Well, even though this is this really bad scene, it still, nevertheless, has this extremely tenuous connection to the highest and hidden All-Father in the form of what is called the scintilla, the spark, the soul spark of divinity. So then the goal of Gnostics born into this unfortunate world is to gather the light together, to save the light. The light is defiled by its presence in the world of material existence, and the light must be gathered. Well, so then the central soteriological concern, that means the central salvational concern of Gnosticism, is how shall we gather the light? And their whole theology then is, what is the light? How should we gather it? And once we have it, what do we do with it? And then there were various answers.